I wanted to do a video for a purification table type problem where you're asked to identify the most effective and least effective steps. From class and practice problems from the textbook, you should know that the most effective step is the step that's going to give you the highest fold increase in specific activity. I'll explain that in a little bit more detail in a second. And then least effective is going to be whichever step causes you to lose your enzyme the most. So the worst thing that can happen during a purification is that you lose your precious enzyme. So that would be the least effective step, is the step that caused you to lose some of that enzyme you're trying to keep, because you can never get it back once you lose it. So let's go through the most effective step first. You're going to be comparing specific activities that happen after each step. So to calculate specific activity, you have to put activity over the total milligrams of protein. This gives you a pretty good readout of the amount of enzyme that you have in your sample. Activity is a measure of how much enzyme you have. The more activity you have in a sample, the more enzyme is there. Your milligrams of protein is just a measure of protein concentration in your sample. Some of which will be your enzyme, most of which in the beginning will not. So a lot of them will just be other proteins from the cell, or the, you know, from those cells that you gathered in the beginning. So for each step, you can calculate the specific activity that is in that sample. So after you isolated crude extract, you have 1,000 units of activity in your sample. You have 10,000 milligrams of protein. The volume that you have doesn't come into the calculation at all, but it's interesting to see that your volume decreases. And this is because you're constantly getting rid of the proteins you don't care about with each successive step. So the volume that you have will decrease. So will the amount of protein that you have. So the total amount of protein will get less and less as you get rid of the proteins you don't want. So after step one, after you just isolated your crude extract, you tested your activity, you have 100,000 units, you have 10,000 milligrams of protein, and so your specific activity would be 100,000 divided by 10,000. And it'll be units per milligram as the units of specific activity. So I'm going to create some more space over here for our calculations. After step two, you have 96,000 over 3,000. So your specific activity will be 32 units per milligram. Then you have 80,000 divided by 400. So your specific activity is then 200. Just putting little lines there to say it's still units per milligram. Then you have 60,000 divided by 100, which is 600 units per milligram. And then lastly, you've got 45,000 units divided by 3, which is 15,000. So your specific activity is going up, and that's what it should be, because you're constantly getting rid of the total amount. You're constantly getting rid of proteins that you don't care about, and so your total amount of protein will go down. You're also losing some of your enzyme too, Because when you look up here at your activities column, activity column, which is a measurement of how much enzyme you have because you're measuring activity, you see that it does go down. But that's because you never have 100% yield in any experimental process. And so you do lose enzyme in every step, but you just want to make sure that you don't lose too much. You want to minimize your losses while maximizing your gains. So which step is most effective? You then ask, how did the specific activity change compared to what I had before? So you look at the fold difference. Did I double my specific activity? Did I triple my specific activity? So to figure out the fold difference, you divide one step by the one previous to it. So 32 divided by 10 is 3.2. So you tripled, you a little bit over tripled your specific activity doing step two. So precipitation with salt caused an increase in specific activity, which allowed your specific activity to a little over triple increase. So then do the same for the next step, 200 divided by 32. Here we see a 6.25 increase, fold increase. 600 divided by 200 is a threefold increase. And 15,000 divided by 600 is a 25-fold increase. So when you look here, the step that allowed you to have the biggest fold increase in specific activity, which means the biggest difference, the biggest increase in the amount of enzyme you were able to keep in comparison to total protein, is step five, where you went from 600 to 1500, it's by a factor of 25. So your most effective is going to be what you did in step five, which is size exclusion chromatography. So of our answers, this one and this one so far match, but now let's do the second half. Which one is the least effective step? So, as I mentioned before, your least effective step represents the worst thing that can happen during a purification. The worst thing that can happen is not having a modest increase in specific activity. The worst thing that can happen is that you straight up lose a lot of your precious enzyme. And so, when we look over here, we see that activity is decreasing each time, which is just a natural factor of nothing's ever perfect. You don't get 100% yield on anything in the lab. But let's look at which step caused the biggest loss of enzyme. So you just subtract one step to the other. When you did step two, you lost 4,000 units of enzyme. When you did step three, you lost 6,000 units of enzyme. When you did step four, you lost 20,000 units of enzyme. And when you did step five, you lost 15,000 units of enzyme. So this was after step one, after step two, after step three, four, and five. So it was step four that you did that caused the biggest loss of enzyme, that you lost 20,000 units. So that step was the least effective. Because even though your specific activity went up, look how much enzyme you lost. That's a lot of units. And so the step was somewhat effective because you increased your specific activity, but you would categorize it as least effective because you lost a lot of enzyme in that step compared to, you lost the most enzyme in that step compared to your other steps. So affinity chromatography step four was the least effective step.